Hello, and welcome to a FaciliTopics presentation. My name is Stormy Friday, and for the next 10 minutes, I'm going to be talking to you about the importance of leadership and management in facility management. I hope you will find this information helpful and also perhaps stimulate your interest in facility management as a profession. First, though, I'd like to tell you a little bit about how I got into facility management. It wasn't something that was on my radar for a career choice initially. I started out with political aspirations and came to Washington, D.C. to get political experience. After working on the Hill, I became a little disillusioned and decided that that wasn't what I wanted to pursue and went to work for a management consulting firm. I became a management consultant, and while I was a consultant, a friend of mine went to EPA as a political appointee, the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency, and asked me if I would come over and reorganize the human resources organization. I agreed, I went and did the project, and when it was over, the administrator of EPA called me into her office and asked me if I would go down and straighten out an organization that she had, that she said did a little light dusting and some yard work. She considered that's what the function of the facility organization was. So I went down and took over the facilities organization. And it turned out it was a little bit more than light dusting and yard work. I had over 1,200 contractors. I had over 200 staff. I had 5 million square feet of real estate, and I had 10 regional offices. Unfortunately, the organization was not considered to be very successful. They also were not considered to be part of the mainstream of what the Environmental Protection Agency's mission was. And so through hard work, using some leadership techniques and some management practices, we transformed the FM organization into one that was highly respected. It was very customer focused. And in fact, it became a model within the federal government for FM organizations. I was asked to leave EPA because I was doing too good a job. And that's a topic for another discussion. But I left, and I knew one of the things I wanted to do was to build leadership and management capabilities for other FM professionals. And so I created the Friday Group, and we have been going strong ever since in doing that for facility professionals around the world. Leadership and management are important to any organization, and FM is no exception. But there are some differences, and I think it's important for you to know what they are. Leaders are the big picture folks. They think about the future, and they are looking towards what is going to happen in the future. They are inspirational, and they create the framework. They also kind of mold the organization into what it is going to become. They create the culture internally. Managers, on the other hand, they get the job done. It's their role to translate that vision, the leader's vision, into action plans. And so they drive the process that allows those action plans to be executed and completed. They also create performance success measures, but leaders focus on the future, managers focus on the here and now, getting things done. The crossover between the two, and there are many, but one of the most important is communication. It's very important for both leaders and managers to communicate extensively with their staff. Leaders set the stage for how the FM organization will function. And so it's important for the FM leader to really understand where the company or the institution is headed, and then align the strategic goals of the FM organization with those of the overall company. Let's say, for example, that the company is thinking about acquiring another company. It's the job of the FM organization to, in fact, go out and make sure that the real estate, the facilities that are being acquired, don't have any problems, or if they do, to make senior management aware of what those would be. It's also important then for the leader to make sure that the staff is motivated and they need to be included so that it's exciting for them to want to achieve that organization vision. It's very, very important. There are characteristics for a leader to be successful in a facility management organization. And one of the things is for them to be flexible and also to be what I call agile. Let's say, for example, that the leader is very interested in improving the customer relationship. And so it's important for the leader to make sure that they understand how that customer relationship can be improved. They also need to work well in the climate of uncertainty. Remember, I said they are the big picture folks, so they need to always be thinking about the future and what may be uncertain. It's important for them to create standards of performance for their staff, but also then they must coach and mentor those folks. And so when things happen, they need to anticipate change and then act accordingly. Management can be said that that is the business of running the FM organization on a day-to-day basis. They are the ones who have to make sure that they deal with the execution of tasks so that those business goals are achieved. It's important that an FM manager understands when you need to assign responsibility to an individual and when you need to create teams, all the while making sure that you have appropriate teamwork. Let's say, for example, an organization within the company needs to move from one location to another. It's the job of the FM manager to assign a project manager for that particular project and then to identify what teams need to be put together in order to make that happen. And then it's the job of the manager to make sure that performance is monitored and that they reward the team and the individual for outstanding performance, and where corrective action is needed, that they initiate that process. It can be said that effective FM managers must set realistic goals, but they also have to be flexible. And they need to think about problems too, but they oversee the work and they delegate the responsibility. Let's take that move example again. It's the responsibility of the FM manager to plan, schedule, and then monitor for deadlines. And so it's the job of the FM manager to make sure that they understand how that move will take place. Perhaps the new space has to be renovated, and so you have to have a plan for that. Then there needs to be coordination with technology folks to put technology in the new space. And then perhaps it's important for the FM manager to figure out how people will be packed up and physically moved to the new space. And so the FM manager establishes those schedules and monitors the deadlines. And it's the job too of the FM manager to make sure that they evaluate the staff performance. The manager also knows how critical it is to get feedback from customers and to involve those customers. And so they must establish a way to make that happen. If you think about it, in an ideal facility management organization, all managers would be leaders and all leaders would be managers, but that isn't always the case. The characteristics of good managers may not always be the characteristics of good leaders. And so think about it. People who may be very good at managing plans and executing schedules and deadlines may not be able to think strategically or think in the future. And so many times people are promoted from managerial positions to leadership positions without having the proper training. On the other hand, some people who may be very good at looking into the future and being very good at being plugged into where the corporate goals are headed may not be able to plan and execute and look at schedules and also to monitor tasks on a daily basis without being given the proper tools. So my takeaway to you here is to think about your characteristics. Do you have the characteristics of a leader, do you think? Or do you have some of the characteristics, the traits of a manager? Or do you have a little of both? Perhaps you will harness those characteristics as you move forward and consider facility management as a career and a profession in the future. Please consider getting in touch with me if you'd like more information. And here's my contact information. Thank you.